Today I'm going to show you how to make a basket weave effect from a photo in Adobe Photoshop. First, go to File and create a new document. From the drop-down, select the pixels. I'll make the height and width 870 by 870. The resolution is 300 pixel inch, and the background contents is black. Then click Create, go back to File, place Embedded, and place your model, adjust the size and position like so. Hit Enter once you're satisfied. Double-click on this, and rename it Horizontal Rose. Press Ctrl-J to duplicate. Double-click on this, and rename it Vertical Rose. Go to Edit, Preferences, and Guides, Grid and Slices. In the Grid section, click the Color box. In the Color Picker, choose any bright color for the grid. Then click OK. I'll make the grid line every 220 pixels. And divide it into 5 subdivisions. Then click OK. Go to View, and make sure Snap is checked. To see the grid, go to Show, and click Grid. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, and click Add to Selection at the top. Go to the top left corner, and drag down a rectangular selection across 3 columns of boxes to the bottom. Skip 1 column, and drag down another rectangular selection across 3 columns. Continue to skip 1 column and drag over 3. Click on the Mask button to make a layer mask of the selection. Select the layer below, go to the top left corner, and drag to the right across 3 rows. Continue to skip 1 row, and drag over 3. Click on the Mask button to make a layer mask of the selection. Hold Ctrl key and click on the layer mask of the horizontal rows to make a selection. Go to the layer mask of the vertical columns, and hold Ctrl, Shift, and Alt key to make a selection that overlaps the vertical columns with the horizontal rows. Go to Select, and Save Selection. I'm going to name this Rose. Then press OK. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Open your Paint Bucket tool. Click inside the second empty box at the top to fill it in. Skip a box, and click on the one after it. Continue this pattern on every other row. Now go to the first empty box on the second row and fill it in. Continue to fill in every other empty box in every other row. Press Q to revert it back into a selection. Press Ctrl-J to cut the shape of the selection from the active layer. Click on the thumbnail of the top layer. Go to Window, and open Channels panel. Hold Ctrl key and click on the rose thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Then close Channels panel. Press Q to make it into a quick mask. This time, click inside the first empty box at the top left, and fill in every other empty box on every other row. Then click on the second empty box of the second row, and continue this pattern. Press Q to make it into a selection, and press Ctrl-J to cut the shape of the selection from the active layer. Press Ctrl-H to hide the grid, right-click on the layer 3 and create clipping mask. Select the layer 1, and then right-click and clipping mask. Click the FX icon and choose the outer glow. The blend mode is multiply. The opacity is 45%. The noise is 0%. The color is black. The spread is 0%. And the size is 35 pixel. Then click OK. To copy the outer glow shadows, go to the FX icon to the right of the layer, and hold the Alt key as you drag it up to the top layer. Select the top layer. Press Ctrl, Shift, Alt, and E to copy and merge all layers. Right-click and convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder, and click Texturizer. Under the Texture, select Canvas. The scaling is 100%. The relief is 3, and the light is top. Then click OK. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.